Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Puffin Between here. Today we've got a real long video. This was literally my first solo queue conquest of season 6, and I decided to record it. And I also wanted to do a kind of retrospective of the match, analyze different plays, help myself get better, and then we'll upload it and see what's going on. Starting right here from even the picks, I know I probably shouldn't analyze casual picks, but I deliberately picked, I made my pick last because I wanted to see what everyone else was doing. And I ended up picking up Thanatos, because I thought we had a fairly decent early game comp between myself, Chiron, Ganesh, and Yormungandr. And then we had Yannis to take us into the late game. I was like, okay, I'll pick Thanatos to help with the Yannis in mid lane. And as it turns out, Thanatos was a great pick against three very tanky boys. Alright, so first of all, I'm going to pick up Assassin's Blessing because obviously I'm jungling. I take tier 1 Jotun's Wrath, a multi-pot, and a health pot. Thanatos doesn't really use mana, so you don't need the mana pot. There's definitely arguments to be said for a tier 1 Hydras over Jotun's, but I pick the Jotun's for just the extra power. We'll go and blink because we want to be aggressive. And if you get the sense I'm being a little bit quiet, it's currently 1 in the morning. I can't sleep, so I was like, you know what, I need to do something with this video. So we're doing something with this video. So as I said, we got a fairly decent early game comp against their much better late game comp. Chiron definitely gets dumpstered by, well, all of us get dumpstered by Ul in the late game if he can get out of this early game. Right now we're just scouting to see if we're about to be invaded by a Hercules. There's a really, really oppressive meta in that the solo laner goes and invades speed by themselves to delay the jungle, and it basically spells instant defeat if they can pull it off and do it right. Previously you would have seen it in a King Arthur video I uploaded, where I didn't quite get the invade. Ideally you delay him for as long as possible, and I kind of missed up the clear there. You want to get the cleaving auto as they spawn for maximum DPS, so slightly DPS loss, but it shouldn't matter. But definitely always hit the big minion, especially with a god like Thanatos who does have cleaving autos. You don't really need to hit the small ones. I did it there purely because I've been in practice, I've been hitting the small one to pull them out and then focusing on just hitting the small one. Just pinging the mid camp so that Yannis knows what's up. Yormungandr should be coming up a little bit, depending on what he took. His clear's pretty slow, there he is right now. We know for a fact he took his 3 because he just used it, but I suspect he took his 2 for jungle clear. He's got very, very slow jungle clear, and especially with Thoth, who would have only provided maybe one shot of Hieroglyphic Assault to clear, it would have taken him quite a while. Our Yorm picks up the totem. I don't care that much for the MP5. Movement speed's always good. Gonna let Yannis clear his midwave whilst I take it, drop his red for him. Perhaps I should have gone up with him to the red. Take an extra point in the one, because I'm gonna look to. I was considering blinking on Thoth and messing his day up basically, but Yannis wasn't here with me. Heading now down to back camps. I'm a little bit slow on my farm, and I'm trying to get used to the map still. I'm gonna walk directly into the tower, but basically we're gonna drop this, head back. Unfortunately, we had no ganking opportunities, so we're just gonna take the knee here, pick up tier 2 boots. We didn't use any of our pots because we weren't aggressing at all. But now we're going to head out back to the speed, asking how Geo is looking for ganks, but as I was typing it, I saw that they were getting pushed all the way back into tower, so I'm not going to be there for at least a little bit. Grab my speed, head on over to Bex. Something I noticed that I should be starting up Thanatosis 3 a little bit earlier. And here we're going to get aggressive on Thoth, silence him so he can't dash. And reasonably clean first blood. Unfortunately, mid's gone, and I don't know why I'm pissing around. Yeah, definitely the call there was probably getting this blue bluff. Blue bluff? English hard. Hopefully Yannis can take control of those mids. There's Yomagunda, he was looking for the invade. Honestly, I should have ignored this. I'm not killing a Yorm, it's a Hercules. I'm not getting XP. But Yannis is here for the fight, so we're gonna silence him out. Yeah, this skirmish is going all kinds of wrong. I simply just shouldn't have been there. Luckily we are gonna, spoiler alert, we're gonna get out. But yeah, there was no reason for that skirmish to occur. If I had just ignored that, gone straight over to mids, I would have gotten the right mids, red back camps, and then potentially ganked on duo. There was no need for me to be on this side of the map. Another side effect of that failed skirmish is that I'm behind in farm again. That's something I've noticed with my games a lot lately, is that I'm always behind. And now I'm behind on my timers, the red's been up for a good 2 minutes by now. It's just everything's behind. So I need to get back on track. So I noticed that there was a bit of a brawl going down on duo. They've put Barkus down into Excrete Threshold. The fact that he's not backing, they didn't need to ping, I knew exactly where he was, thanks to Execute passive, and we easily take the kill there. No cheeky red. But we thought it had taken a lot of damage from that Yannis. Alright, so I want to talk about this sequence right here. I've just cleared mid. My jungle is down, apart from right back camps. And so I don't know why I'm looking left. I'm like, I shouldn't even bother with this Hercules. All I'm doing is wasting time instead of backing. Getting some wards, getting tier 2. I'm not really doing anything, and now my speed is coming up. That whole, let's say, 30-40 seconds was a complete and utter waste, and would have been better spent going back. Because now I risk falling even further behind. I've only just hit level 7. I think Yorm's like been level 7 in a bit. He's invading. All in all, that's just really, really bad. And that early sequence of plays also means that I don't have that additional power that I need for this fight here. So I scythe Jormungandr, silence him. Apparently Ganesh silence doesn't actually prevent that from doing anything. But on the plus side, I've successfully pushed out Jormungandr, so now we can kind of go at this fight. Throw a scythe at Barkus. Why are you ulting Barkus, you idiot? So I fly all the way back to mid camps. Meanwhile, they're still fighting, so I'm forced to go all the way back. I do have Blink, I do have Scythe. I blink in behind Ulla. Burn his Aegis, he dies. Barkus gets knocked up. Why did I silence him there? Why did I silence? I throw a scythe. I kill him. Unfortunately, Thoth got away. I call for to attack the Gold Fury because we just won that fight. We're reasonably healthy. I'm going to tank it for a little bit because I do have healing. But obviously, in the back of my mind, Thoth got out. So, and there's the wall right now. Plus side, he didn't charge it fully, so we were a little bit lucky there. So I'm going to go in, clear purple. And then after all of that, now it's only now that I'm backing. Should I get my full Jotun's Wrath, and I can start building my Spirit Robe, because I'm going to be shifting into more of a tanky hybrid. Basically putting the emphasis on my execute in the late game, because we're not far ahead enough for me to warrant going full damage. They've got three very tanky boys. I need to be that additional frontliner, because Ganesh obviously can't tank everything. Jormungandr's not exactly good at peeling, so I'm going to be transitioning into more of that hybrid Orisa. It's very difficult to miss Scythe on Jormungandr because of how big he is. However, he's gone ahead and uses. I stupidly type when I really shouldn't have done. If I hadn't have done, I could have. I might have been able to save Thoth. I certainly would have killed Thoth a lot sooner. Yeah, wasting time there was just a big detriment. I say it's very difficult to miss Scythe on Jorm, and I go ahead and miss it in the very next cast. Good job. Jan should be able to pick this up. Regardless, I'm just gonna drop it because I'm looking to back. After that. Am I not looking to back? Oh, okay. I guess I've got full health, so. I guess we're just looking to AFK farm, reacquire control of the jungle. Hopefully these mids are up. They are not. Feels bad. Alright, I guess we're just going to go back speed and then blue. Probably a good call. Thanks. That's certainly the most efficient. Okay, good. It hasn't been a total waste. Ooh, Janus took a spill in mid. I wonder what happened there. Why are you looking at Hercules? Yeah, no, fuck that right off. Yep, nothing's happened. Good. Okay, good. You finally made it to mid. There was going to be no one to soak up their XP, so good. Ping the oracles, because oracles are up. Cancel that. Oracles are not up. Barkus is coming in, quickly grab mids, and we're going to just dunk Barkus. Ganesh creates a beautiful, beautiful ult-dash combo. That was great. This Ganesh played really well. Possibly MVP? I'm not sure. Janus? I don't know why I said Janus. I meant Thoth. But Jormungandr's being a sneaky snake. And so something that I started to notice around about now was the possibility that Thoth was on console. So he's going to be a reasonably easy target for me to kill because he's got a slow turning circle, and which means I can just blink on him, silence him. He's going to be panicking because he can't move, and then you just scythe auto and he's fucking dead 9 times out of 10. Unfortunately, is this wrong? Quite possibly this is wrong of me.
is down.
Yeah, I should not be on the Foth. I try go for it. There was potentially a way for me to get the kill there if I had pulled the trigger slightly earlier. And there's a Barkus. He's not even drunk, so don't know what he's doing. Where's the Yermigermidoo? Now, I know I said mana wasn't really a concern for Thanatos, but I'm running rather low. It's been a while since I've gone back. I've got nearly 3k gold in hand. So, Yanis ults in. I call for him to be careful, because it's going to be a rough fight.
Enemy spotted. Be careful left.
Okay, good. It looks like I'm going into the Void Shield. I'm following through with the plan. I haven't really been fighting with Chiron, though, so I'm not sure how valuable the Void Shield here is. It's almost like if someone were to get Void Stone. So Void Stone on this team would be really valuable. Probably from Jormungandr. Jormungandr uses it better than Ganesh, I feel. Speaking of Jormungandr, big snick. Yeah, he snicks off. We should definitely. Yep, okay. I dropped the Gold Fury because it's not a good idea for this to happen. I just didn't want to potentially just get absolutely destroyed there. Hercules in mid lane. There's no way we're killing him. Once again, I've fallen behind in farm. Good old Hercules, always taunting, being unkillable. Yes, I am well aware of the Ulla that's sitting in the jungle there. Foth goes in on the Chiron. We save the Chiron. I go in. Foth unfortunately healed back up and turns out Jormungandr managed to get down. I need to time my scythe's my reap better with Ganesh silencing. But plus side, Ganesh has got my back and I gladly accept his kill. I call for the attack on middle lane. Maybe it's not the correct choice. But I figured there's four of us. Let's see if we can't push down this tower. As I clear mid camps, because again I'm slightly behind. But I chunk Herc with that. And then dunk the Thoth. Sadly I have no mana. But Chiron gets the follow-up and secures the kill, and now I'm just trying to leave. Fat boy is after my penis. Good. Thank God, Toby, you actually were back. So at this point in the game, I've got my Void Shield and my beads. Again, I'm not sure how valuable Void Shield was actually in this game. But we're at the point now where we're looking to group up, take objectives. There's the Oni Fury, which is very important. Oh, Chiron is getting the Wangledang. Not a lot we can do there. If I had gone in, I probably would have died. Same with Yanis. Yanis did have his ult, so perhaps he should have ulted in that general direction. Try and get Chiron out. At this point, I keep saying this, but I want to hammer this home for myself primarily. Need to get better at farming. I always find that when I'm playing by myself, my farm is always always lackluster in comparison to when I'm actually playing with people. And I don't know what it is. It's like maybe I have a mentality that I've got to help teammates like even more so than when I'm solo queue, rather than playing with a team. In the meantime, this Thoth, I miss a Death Scythe, and so if you miss Scythe, you just gotta bail in the safest way possible. But I'm actually coming back from it. I miss a second Scythe. Just get out, dude. Just get out. Yeah. Unfortunately, my scythe didn't go out in time, and so I take my first death of the game. So, at this point of the game, I'm looking for one of two things to happen. Find a squishy butthole to insert my scythe, or one tanky boy within execute range. Evil Snick stole my speed, so I'm upsetty. So I call Defend the Gold Fury, and that's for one reason in particular. At the time of the call, no one was visible on the map. I saw Hercules over in right, and so I called to attack the Gold Fury. Now, is this a good call? Probably not. I make myself visible on the map so that they know that I am here. Jormungandr's over in left, and I know at least two are over in left, both Hercules and Jormungandr. And there's the Thoth. So we take the only Fury for free. Rotating over to come and deal with a snake, and Hercules says no. Fucking hate Hercules. I'm gonna try and ult one sneaky snake. And I just saw him pop up on the other side of this, so it feels real bad. And I'm getting the wangle dang right now, so I just need to. I'm doing my best to try and uke. And, successful ukes. I'm just waiting for my scythe to come up, waiting for a moment that it's safe to come in. And my lord, Hercules is tanky. I'm just trying to heal up on those back camps. I call to attack the fire giant. We've pushed out two of them. The biggest threat now in terms of our fire giant is going to be the Bacchus Intoxicate. Jormungandr is a little bit low. But I think we have good enough damage. Ganesh is on the lookout for unfriendlies. Unfortunately, he gets knocked up. But it looks like we're going to be able to take fire giant. You saw Bacchus come in. And there's Ul. And whilst we're here, we may as well get Pyro. And there is the Bacchus. We get the Pyro, but it was real rough. And now we're forced to fight, essentially. But luckily, Ul is dead as shit. I'm telling our guys to back and spend. Chiron wants to get frisky with this Bacchus, though. And why are you going as well? I guess I've got an ultimate to contribute. Maybe we ought to get this. Yeah, no, and there it goes. Chiron is like 100% dead here. There's no way he's not. That's a sneaky snake again who's ulting, so I can't target him. So I switch my focus onto Hercules. Silence, he's knocked up. We've got a Pestilence, I hope, on Ganesh, or at least he's building his way to one. I'm building my way towards the Brawlers to deal with that. Since we're here, let's attack mid lane. I desperately need to back for the Brawlers. We still have Pyro up. So, positive reinforcement for the randoms. It's always a good idea. What am I grabbing? I'm not sure about the Hydras here. Now I'm thinking about it. A Titan's Bane at this stage of the game was certainly better. Hydra's, I feel like its value has dropped off significantly. You know, we're almost 25 minutes into the game. It's much better in the early stages of the game. Certainly tier 2 anyway. But it's no point keeping the Assassin's Blessing around anymore. I'm also, yeah, you can tell you're super far behind. I realistically, for jungle it should take 20 minutes to reach level 20. We got both those oracles, that was pretty lucky, so I'm gonna just chunk Buckus with this. I ult. Fucking miss. classic. Well, whilst I'm here, I'm gonna just drop this for whoever wants it. Buckus is too far away. I turn my attention to the squishy birdman. Who can't do it. I probably didn't need to scythe in there, but I scythed him to make sure. I definitely only needed one order. Is Chiron gonna get out? Well, Jormungandr is chasing him the fuck down. Chiron probably should have left already. We're gonna get some additional silences, and there's just nothing we can do to help him. Chiron was in the wrong place at the wrong time. I got completely juked by Hercules there. That backstab I did not expect, and Ulug just died. So I'm going to turn my attention now to Jormungandr, put some extra CC. And yeah. Long ass fight, but we got there. We know where Buckus is. Put a ward down in case he tries to sneak. I see Ganesh is also taking the route of positive reinforcement. Basically, the plan is, let's kill this Phoenix before they come back up. I have to beat the stun, otherwise I'll start taking too much damage from Phoenix, and this is where you really, really need a hunter. And that's where this Titan's Bane would have come in so much, in so clutch in comparison to the Hydras. Luckily, I silence and scythe the Buckus to stop him from killing me. And I just ult out. You never want to be ulting out. It's always it feels bad when you have to ult out as Thanatos. All right, I'm calling for the team to prep for fire. Basically, we just need to be able to take the fight, pick off some key targets, especially as Ul is still level 17, Buckus is level 13, like he's been absolutely shit-stomped. Ganesh has done really well this game, as I said earlier. But basically, when I say prep Fire Giant for those who are relatively new to Smite, you set up wards around all the major choke points around Fire Giant. Speaking of which, Thoth used one of them. This area right here is another one. Basically, if enemies arrive, the idea is that you drop Fire Giant and then kill them if you can, or push them out. And if you can do it without resetting Fire Giant and then take it immediately afterwards, it's even better. I'm just waiting for Jormungandr to pull fire, and then we're on our way. I mistimed the pools there. But it looks like we're going to get Fire Giant without much hassle. Don't know why Chiron dashed there. That seemed utterly pointless. I called to attack left lane because it's the only tower still left standing. We'll drop a ward to cover that choke point again. And in come two large boys. And by large boys, I mean like one fat boy and then the large boy. In Buckus and Hercules, respectively. So, Thoth has separated himself. So I'm waiting for my blink to come back up, or am I? Essentially, I'm looking to blow up Thoth or Ul as quickly as possible without using my ult. By ult. Anyway. We dunk the Ul. We smack him in the penal, will silence out the burp from Bacchus. Hercules is within getting smacked in the dick range. And so is Yorm. And Yorm dies. Try to go for a cheeky scythe there on Hercules, but I don't think it would have got him even if it did hit him. We bring down the Phoenix. Now in hindsight we probably could have pushed for the win here, but I'm certainly much more safe than I probably should be. And so I called to attack the middle Phoenix. Plus we didn't have the Chiron. He fell at some point during that fight. So his range damage would have been real helpful. I made the wrong call here. I'm calling to attack the right Phoenix. Definitely the correct call was with Giannis in retreating. Retreating was the call as the enemies are coming back online, reviving. But we're still fighting. Giannis got a really chunky kill, so I ult just in case something happens. Honestly, again, you don't really want to be ulting for no reason, Thana. It's a real feels bad. His execute is a very powerful tool, especially in this stage of the game. When, you know, respawn timers are long, killing the Yorm or the Hercules through all of their protections and their health would have been super valuable. We're now grabbing this Gold Fury or the Primal Fury. This is going to give us a buff against jungle camp monsters, but this is the first instance of it. So, it's not overly useful at 30 minutes. At this stage of the game, it becomes a you kill fire giant slightly faster. Alright, so here's a mistake right here. I've got 3,500 gold. Instead of an elixir of defense, I probably should have bought elixir of speed, sold my boots, and bought the Titan's Bane. That was a perfect opportunity for it, and I just didn't take it. Alternatively, you sell it and grab like a mantle of discord. Spoiler alert. That line of thought happens at least, I think, twice more in this game. It's pretty crazy that I just, for some reason during games, I just forget that elixir of speed isn't a thing. I'm so unused to it being there, and I'm sure a lot of people are as well, but yeah, at this stage of the game, that elixir probably, that defense elixir should have been a speed elixir, and let's dunk on this Voth. How'd you miss? How did you miss? You're dumb. But Thoth's gone. So, unfortunately, Ganesh is almost about to die, and so is Giannis. And yeah, this was a big rip. I get absolutely munched on by a Jormungandr. I say bad call my B, because again, I want to stay in good standing. But realistically, it was just a really, really bad fight for us. Poorly timed, poorly executed. Chiron, yeah, got a kill, but we traded 2 for 2. In this position, it's not great. Bacchus dies. It turns out Ganesh got punched into the fountain. So, that's another failed siege. Definitely need the Chiron here to help us take this. Yes, I have a penetration buff, but I don't have the good sustained damage. I don't have the confirm that Chiron and Giannis do. Hercules throws the boulder in really, really preemptively, and honestly, we almost lose that fire giant due to some less than optimal. Less than optimal zoning, but I get an execute, which on a real tanky boy, and then follow up with a double onto the Bacchus. So all in all, not a huge loss, and I missed the silence onto Thoth. Once again, Chiron finds himself bodied by a large snake. And the large snake gets the honor, so that's two of our carries. Down, which is a real big issue. I'm trying my best to take out these Phoenixes, make it worth, but once again, It's the jungle support and solo that are still alive. And somehow I'm tanking this. But realistically, I'm just trying to get both these phoenixes down again, keep them busy at least for another siege. I go up looking for the Yorm, and it's as I was clicking, I saw that he had activated Aegis, so feels bad. Barkus hasn't learned that I can just silence him out of that yet. And once again, we are forced to retreat. Every time we take Fire Giant, we siege, we get two phoenixes, and we can't do anything off that because both our mid and ADC are dead. And I'm at this point just trying to leave. This large stack has destroyed me, and I take a point blank ult by Thoth to deal 10 damage. And unfortunately, I think Ganesh is probably gonna lose here. My mistake was going into the jungle there instead of just running up lane. So this is the second instance of what's a elixir of speed. I end up selling the Hydras because it's not doing anything. Free Bulwark of Hope to help protect me. Primarily against Jormungandr, as it turns out. Jormungandr is the source of all my woes. But again, it should have been a Titan's Bane. If I'm the only physical damage source surviving, I needed the Titan's Bane. So right here, I'm calling for a push on right. This Phoenix has been the bane of our last two sieges. Mostly because I've called for it to be attacked and no one's followed it. I just want it down. It also opens up for the inevitable fourth Fire Giant. You always want to get this Phoenix before taking Fire Giant, so. And plus it's the only one we haven't taken down, and we've staggered the Phoenixes pretty decently, I would say, if we manage to take this one. My focus is 100% on not the Phoenix. And once again, Chiron gets picked off in the back, and this starts off as a bad fight. So we should retreat, regroup. I don't know how Chiron manages to keep finding himself in a position where he's caught out and just immediately dumpstered on. I retreat into the jungle, Jormungandr's fucking following me. And he is a boy that does a lot of damage. Luckily, Cleaving Water is a pretty OP, and I take care of that Jormungandr. Why are we fighting the Hercules? I focus on the Ulla. Jorm and I can... There he goes. We got there. Barkus is being a fool, so he gets muted and probably not at the good time. But luckily, your boy Ganesh has my back and I dumpster the taunting nerd. I got pretty baited into muting him because I pretty much, like, the moment someone starts taunting, I instantly mute. So. I'm calling for the attack on Phoenix. Why? Because it's a 5v2. We should definitely get this, and somehow Thoth manages to get out of the Ganesh. Bye. I will happily take that kill. Your team has destroyed a middle enemy Phoenix. Yes. And Ganesh is a fucking god, and he catches Hercules' dash. That's amazing. But Big Snake once again crashes on the Chiron, leaving us without a hunter to deal with the Titan. And now they're all coming back up, leaving once again the jungle, the support, and the solo to fail the siege. for a fourth time. However, all is not lost. They must have thought I've retreated by now. So Yorm is still chasing the Ganesh. So Big Snake gets dumpstered. Hi Hercules. Ganesh saves me like a boss again. And we're now just leaving. The longer this goes on, the longer our respawn timers are going to be, and the harder it's going to be to close out this game. Once again, I ignore Elixir of Speed. One day I'll get Elixir of Speed and replace it with Titan's Bane. One day. Today is not this day. Don't know why Barkus just took 2 power shots. Now I know I called Defend the Fire Giant here. Because that's where I thought they were going to go, but for some reason they backed off and went to the right hand side of the map. Cancel that. I will war. So we get this gold, this Fire Giant for free. I do see the Froth patrolling outside. There goes the Gold Fury. And there's the Froth now. I see him ulting, so I go up to ult him and dunk his face. And looks like Giannis ulted him. I didn't even see the through space in time come out, but he did it. And we've got some fucking awful tanking going on here at the Fire Giant, to the point where Chiron once again dies, so our Hunter, whom we need to deal damage to the Titan, is once again dead. And this late game is such a fucking mess. It's a problem with solo queuing. It's really tough to finish off games when you can't communicate with your team. I'm not sure if it was on us to save Chiron or Chiron to not be in a bad position. I'll be honest, I haven't really been paying attention to what he's doing. I'm unsure how he's unable to stay alive through these fights, not just poke from range, but yeah. In saying that, our peel isn't the greatest. We've got Giannis portals and Ganesh knockups and silences and Yorm knockups, but realistically, we don't have a lot of peel. And Chiron's got decent self peel, you know, he dashes away, he knocks you back. I take a knockup here from the Hercules. Let's get this fucking Phoenix down for the 7,000,000th time. I missed my scythe because a minion blocked it, but it's okay, Ulla's down. That Phoenix is about to come up again, and there's the Thoth. This time we're gonna go in and try and kill the Titan. Silence out of the Barkus, it's all good. And we are losing again. We just can't quite manage to finish the job, you know? There is a large snake following me. Think about dunking the Thoth, but that's a very, very bad plan. And so we just have to leave. Luckily, they've got minions pouring in, the Titan's low, they have to sit back and defend, which gives us some time to regroup. I come and just clear these out. Luckily, minions were successful in getting that Phoenix, so yay. Wasn't all for naught. Once again, Elixir of Speed. What is it? Why are we attacking Barkus here? I guess we're just trying to get any amount of pressure that we can. Let's chunk this boy. That's a pretty valuable teamfight ult down. And Barkus is taking out Barkus, I think, was important there. I think I just needed to take out, just guaranteed take out one enemy. We're going to dunk Thoth right now. Once again, Chiron goes down. Maybe that's on me. I didn't protect him. And Giannis, once again. But Jormungandr goes in and goes, bleh, big snick. Bleh. And that's the game. We eventually closed out. Anyway, that was my first solo queue game of this season. It was a fun game, but my lord, did it go on 4 years. Something I've noticed about this season, especially when I'm not playing in a full squad, is that games go on forever. And maybe I should be transitioning my god pool, my playstyle, into more late game hyper carries. Maybe that's why Shibalanke is so potent and popular right now, is that you do get to these later stages and you just need that straight we win card, you know. So from the jungle, Nemesis, Kali, definitely fucking dumpsters in these late game exchanges. And maybe with a Kali I could have just gone left click, just hold down that left mouse button and just shredded through nets. Anyway guys, that's going to be the game. Thank you very much for watching. Hope this was insightful. Maybe I'll go back and watch this once I put it together and be like, yeah, that's true. Although I've seen this same game 3-4 times now and I've taken the hits. And yeah. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.